Welcome everyone, thank you very much for joining me today on my latest episode. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you very much for clicking on my video. And alright everyone, if you're very new to my channel, hit that subscribe button. I do all the latest news, transfer news, and I'll be doing it all through for the next couple of years. So I do regular videos on Liverpool Football Club, but what I love about this channel, I made it specifically for all of us to communicate and interact. I love nothing more than us all to have a good gab and talk about footy, but specifically more about Liverpool, the club that we all love. But welcome everyone, thank you very much for clicking on my video, as always. And hello, hit that subscribe button, as I've said, put the notifications on so we can all interact and engage in the stuff that we love. Come on. But yeah. Right, I've got a packed show today. Obviously, my last two videos have been about you-know-who, Keita, and the chairman of RB Leipzig has come out today, and I'll talk a bit about that later on. But it's very much exciting. It's even though the stuff coming out, but it's very much looking very promising at the minute, whatever you might read, but it's very much, if you haven't seen my other videos, it's a player that I think that will elevate Liverpool's midfield and it's not just a player, oh, he's expensive. He will put our midfield onto another level just with his quality. Yet, 70 million, you might say, it might be a bit too much, but it's 70 million very much well spent. And the way in which Jürgen signaled him out, he will get him, and he's very much confident in his ability. So, I more or less, we should all back Jürgen and trust him. And I trust Jürgen with every player that he brings through the door. So, it will work out. But, yeah. As always, but first off, to start off, all I can say is I've seen the subscription. Like, it's ridiculous. Thank you for 900 plus subs. I started off not expecting at all anything, but thank you very much. That means a lot to me. We're very close to 1,000, as I mentioned. I'll do a special 1,000 video subscriber episode, but that is ridiculous. And honestly, I'm talking to you heart to heart. Thank you very much for everyone that's subscribed, and if you're watching this video, hit that subscribe button. I really do appreciate it, so you can just join us and we can all, as I've said about a million times, we'll have a gander about Liverpool Football Club. But thank you very much everyone, I really really do appreciate every single one of those subscribes and the views as well and the likes as well. How's that? No, I'm gonna jinx it now. On my last video I've got like 160 odd likes and there's no dislikes. I've just jinxed it now. Watch everyone just like the video. But thank you very much. That is ridiculous. Right? But if you like this video, smash that like button again. I know you all can, but it'd be appreciated. But yeah, let's get started. I'll do a breakdown of what I've got coming up today. Gerrard's first day of his becoming a manager, really. The under-18s, first day. It's like a little kid at his first day of going to school. But Gerrard, and I'll talk a bit about RB Leipzig, as I've mentioned, their chief executive officer has come out and had a talk to all the press over there in Germany. Yeah, I think he's absolutely talking out of his backside, to put it basically in layman's terms. But yeah, and Didi Hamann, the absolute German legend for us, Big Diddy, he's talked a bit about the players. He's quoted saying Liverpool need more players, so check that out. And there's a player out the door as well. But yeah, quick shout out to, I think it's Ryan Brewster. It's one of the young lads. He put on his Snapchat before he broke his foot, or he's done something really bad to him. And he was in our very after season friendly. He had a little run out, but that's guttering. Any young lad or anyone that plays football, it looked like a bad injury. So shout out, lad, anyway. Hope you get better soon. But yeah, right, a little memory, quick one before we start the show. 10 years today that we signed Fernando Torres. Wow, that is ridiculous. I don't know. Let me know what you were doing 10 years ago, like when we signed Fernando Torres. That is flown by. That is absolutely ridiculous how much time has passed. I was a little kid. Well, not a little kid, but I was 12. That is ridiculous. That only seems like yesterday. So let me know what you were doing 10 years ago when we signed Fernando Torres. We're in a shop getting groceries, or you know, cheeky as the chip or whatever. But yeah, let me know, and a shout out, obviously. Oh yeah, quick one, Dosena as well. It marks the day that we signed Dosena. What a player. Like, he literally went off his head and scored two goals against two of the best teams in that time. He scored against United and Real Madrid. Not two bad teams to score against. The naughty dinks over the keeper as well. I love that Van der Sar one at Old Trafford. When he just went, dink. That just was icing on the cake. Right, shout out to Quick Lad as well. Thank you very much. Shout out to Liverpool Football Talk. Sorry, can't remember your name, mate, but I only checked that. I found his channel last night in the early hours when I should be going to bed, but I found his channel. And he does quality videos. I'll leave the link in the description. And hopefully I can do a collab with you, mate. All the way in America. So I'll speak to you very soon. But check out his channel. I very much recommend it. All Liverpool content. He does it with his dad. And rightly so. But yeah, check that out. Right. The first one. Gerrard. Sorry for the long intros. But it was a special show, really. The 900 subscribers. But yeah, right. Gerrard begins work as Liverpool under-18s manager. On Monday, as pre-season training started at the club's academy complex, and he's already itching to take the reins for the first competitive game. The Reds legend welcome home his new batch of players to the Kirby and unwanted day as it's an unwanted day of assessment, fitness tests, and the typical pre-season training that we all, if you've done played football or whatever, like you know, pre-season is not a very good time. Everyone hates it, basically. Excuse me, sorry everyone. Yeah, so he's quoted talking to Liverpool Football Club on the website. Gerrard, I'm excited. It's been waiting for it all through the summer. And I had one eye on it whilst I've been having a bit of a break. It's here now and I'm really excited about getting my teeth into it. 95% of planning was done at the back end of last year. And I did a lot of planning with Alex. He's been a big help for me. And to get it sorted today. I feel ready, we're organised, and we've got a fantastic staff around me. I just can't wait for the first game of the season now. Obviously, Stevie's joined by his new look backroom staff, which includes the arrival of Jordan Milsom from the first team setup. That's quite good because there's going to be a link between the young lads to obviously the first team, so that's a very astute move from Stevie. He quickly goes on to say, the players are lucky. They might not realise it because they haven't been at many other clubs, but Liverpool are very well down the line in terms of sports science, as quoted from Stevie G. There's a lot more of that interview. I didn't want to bore you anyway. Well, not bore you, but like literally, check it out. Oh, wait, that's of all the stories that I got today. Definitely check out what Stevie said. There's so much on it, but that is a quality interview. I am excited to see him in his new role. Let me know if you're excited to see Stevie in his new role. Oh, we all wish we were like young and playing in the under-18s team to actually get played tour footy by the absolute legend, Steven Gerrard! But yeah, sorry, I've got a bit mad there. But yeah, right. So yeah, check that story out. Good luck, Stevie, lads. Hopefully you're bringing some quality players through. I'm sure you will. Integrate them into the first team from Jurgen Klopp. Right, here we go. As I mentioned, Mr. RB Leipzig, CEO, says the club are immune to offers for Naby Keita and calls topic boring. You know what, mate? You're boring and you're absolutely off your head if you're saying any club in world football is immune to offers from anyone. Do you think Juventus were like all in the boardroom when he had Pogba? Right, sir. Someone says to him, the director's now, we've just been offered £100 million for Paul. Are we going to reject it? And everyone's sitting around, and if it was RB Leipzig's chairman, CEO, going, yeah, no, but if he worked at Juve, and he went, no, we reject it. And everyone's looking like, oh, no player in the right mind is worth £100 million, nor is no player worth £70 million. But yeah, that's the going rate in the market, and if Liverpool are willing and prepared in, they're prepared, and that's a big main thing, that they're going to submit literally an offer for £70 million. Are you telling me that CEO's going to turn around and say, right, no, we're not letting him go for £70 million? No. Now, if that was Coutinho or any of our players or anyone in world football, you're not going to turn down that sheer amount of money. That is ridiculous. So, right, I'll tell you what he's had to say. Olivier Milzlaff, Leipzig's chief executive officer, has insisted the club are immune to offers for star player Naby Keita and Frosberg as well. It's believed that Leipzig star midfielder Keita is obviously talked about, but it's quoted saying Times Paul Joyce said in the Times saying that the Reds are stepping up their interest this week and ready to make a bid worth around £70 million. If you haven't seen my other videos, I've talked about that. So obviously Paul Joyce is very much a reliable source from the British press. He wouldn't chat nonsense if he didn't have anything to go off. So yeah, check out my other two videos out on the channel. It's a deal that looks very much is going forward. So yeah, the German publication Blind have reiterated again today that Leipzig do not want to sell. Yeah, we know that. But believe the bid around 70 million could tempt them into sale. That coincides with what their CEO is saying. But he's quoted as saying, Minzlaff. Sorry, mate, if you're watching, but I can't. I'm not German. There's probably loads of Germans going, you're saying that completely wrong. And probably everyone is going, right, but sorry for pronunciation wrong. I'm a Scouser. All right, lad. But yeah, I'm not the best at pronunciation. But yeah, right, here we go. He's quoted as saying, yes, that topic is boring. It doesn't seem like a bid has been submitted by Liverpool yet, but they will be hoping that the players will leave, obviously. So he's quoted as saying it was boring. Yeah. Keita is going to be in a red shirt by the end of this window. If it takes the last day, obviously when Southampton signed Mane from wherever they signed him from, the Austrian club, they were all out. And there's been clubs and Germans in the past. We can rattle them all off, but there's been everyone around world football, that's their stance. They do a stance going, right, we're not going to sell them. 2 weeks later, they're getting pictured in the other rival's kit. It makes no sense. Obviously, he's having to say that. So he's, oh, it's boring. But yeah, watch this space. Yeah, it's not the last, and you're not going to hear from the last, probably from him. It'll probably come out tomorrow and I'm flip at everyone again. Or the British press, oh, talking nonsense and all that. But yeah. That's RB Leipzig's CEO. Sorry, everyone. But let's go. Right. Absolute legend. Liverpool still need to sign more players, says Didier Hamann. Liverpool still need to strengthen this summer in order to challenge to the Premier League next season, according to Didier Hamann. Obviously, the legend played from 1999 to 2006, and he was pivotal. The absolute legend in that Istanbul game. But there's been so many other games that he was an absolute legend in. But he's quoted as saying to Sky, I'll leave all the interviews, as always, in the description. There's still areas of the team that need addressing, Diddy said. If you look at the left-back position, yeah, we've all mentioned in the comments the last couple of videos. In the left-back position, I don't think that they should be going into the season with Milner at left-back. That's what I've been saying, and probably loads of yous have been saying as well. He's been a tremendous player for Manchester City and Liverpool, but he is not a left back. So I think the left back position has to be addressed. Yes, it does, Diddy. Yes, it does. As we've all mentioned, all of us have talked about in the comment section, it is very much a big, big area we need to talk about. As well as the left back, the German also wants Liverpool to bring in a central defender and central midfielder before the transfer window shuts. He goes on to say a bit more, maybe a centre back, and then I think central midfield, because other teams have been better equipped in central midfield. So I would like to see another three or four players come into the club. Salah is a good signing, but at the same time, that is probably where Liverpool are strongest. The creative department with Mane, Phil, Adam and Roberto, obviously. So I think we need at least another three to four players. Yes, Diddy, lad. He's talking absolute sense there, as he always does. But yeah, let me know what you think about Diddy talking about three to four players. Well, excuse me. Like players, we've all talked about left back as a priority for all of us, as Diddy quite mentioned there. Centre back and a centre mid. And where else, if he says, if we address those 3 years, which we more or less looking at like we are, where would that leave if he's that fourth player? If we could get those three positions sorted, centre back, left back and centre midfield, where would you like to add? Do we need another winger, another centre mid, another centre back cover? Let me know below. Where would you see that fourth player that we actually did get a fourth player in? For me, it's a winger. I think we need another winger. You might be like, what? But another winger would complement. On top of, if we do get our primary targets, that'd be naughty. That'd be one of the best transfer windows if we get Salah, Keita, and obviously a decent left back in. And whoever we sign, and Van Dijk, if it happens, that would be, for me personally, one of the best transfer windows that has happened in this football club in so long, very much so. So, right, the Liverpool player that has quit, as obviously I brought to you like 2 weeks ago, Derby County have signed Wisdom. Obviously, I'll leave the picture there. There he is, Wisdom, on the Twitter account. Derby announced it today. Liverpool Andres Wisdom has quit Liverpool to sign for Derby County, as it was announced on Monday. The Championship club have announced on their official website and social media channels that if they have wrapped, obviously they've wrapped up the transfer of the 24-year-old after he completed a medical. Wisdom penned a 4-year deal running up until 2021, and he's agreed personal terms and he's went on holiday. All the best, Wisdom, lad. Obviously, all the best. It didn't at all work out for him. He had his little run in the team and he got obviously got loaned out. And I think he won the league and double with the club. Was it RB Leipzig or whoever he went out alone last season? But all the best, lad. Wisdom, he's an absolute tank of a man. And I'm sure we'll see him back in the Premier League with Derby County because they've got a quality team coming up from the Championship. But yeah, that is very much it for today. Whee! Sorry it's been a proper long one, but let me know. Get involved, every single one of you. And thank you, as always. If you're still watching till now, you're absolute legends. Thank you very much. So yeah, let me know. Address those situations. And if there's any questions that you want to ask me or get involved, hit that like and subscribe button. Join the family. And thank you, as always, everyone. Yeah, it's been a pleasure. You'll never walk alone. And I'll see you very much tomorrow. Whee!